疫后拼复苏，为美国青少年带来机会。
Prior to pandemic, we should be easily get approximately 15 to 20 employee part-time of those high school student or college student. And this year so far, we got only one. And so that is very unusual. The source is just not there.
像是这家冰淇淋店，往年中人有七成都是高中和大学生。在历经去年一整年的疫情冲击，随着各州解封，即将迎来繁忙的夏季，业者出招砸钱找人手。
We also raised the wages by 15 to 25% to our existing employee, regardless they are full time or part time. We planning to give another bonuses to people that has been working for me more than 2 years.
纽约时报报道，今年夏天可以赚取的工资将会是近年待遇条件最高。以游乐园为例，去年暑假时薪高中生约$9，但今年却从$13起跳。新进员工甚至还能获得价值$300的免费机票。高中生瑞秋看准机会，早已向多家连锁餐饮业丢履历。
Do you know this person and do they like you? And it's kind of getting competitive where some people have the upper hand. I'm really excited to finally be able to put on some uniform.If I hate it or if I don't, but like just being able to contribute.
不只能赚取零用钱，回馈父母，还能增加竞争力。青少年打工族薪资调高是全美各地缩影。随着美国经济重启，也满足市场需求。
Employers are suddenly scrambling to hire workers as we are reopening more parts of the economy, and these are often entry-level, low-wage jobs in things like.Restaurants and hotels and retail stores. So exactly the segment where youth would be able to fill those kinds of jobs. And they're often very willing to be able to go out and take those jobs right now, especially since employers are even increasing the rate of pay.
不过并非每个青少年都能找到工作。
It's always been the case that youth of color, particularly inner city, low-income youth, have difficulty finding job opportunities. On the other hand, lots of white youth live in places that have more job opportunities. Their parents are connecting them to different job opportunities. And so we have this uneven playing field that's been in existence for years.
尽管白种人工作机会相对更多，根据统计，自2008年以来，美国16到19岁的青少年以现在投入劳动市场比例最高。光是今年4月，约有25万名青少年有工作。除了暑期能够打工赚钱，美国政府极力复苏经济，撒币补贴下青少年，同时填补疫后劳动的空窗期。环宇新闻严欣怡综合报道。
请您继续锁定环宇新闻网以及 YouTube 环宇新闻频道，并且记得订阅、开启小铃铛，接收更多全球新闻报道。